Hey everybody, Alex Goff here at the FloRugby Studios, looking at Ireland versus Wales, and what a beautiful try it was for Jacob Stockdale to just get Ireland going and end up fueling their win against Wales this past weekend. I wanted to have a look at it. First of all, because, just lovely to look at. Let's have a look at it now. But I also have some problems with one little moment inside there to see. Maybe it should have been disallowed.
Look, Carey here going through. Here's Kilcoyne. Marmion. Carty thought about it, but then he made the break into the space. That's wonderful play. Conway coming off that wing, swerving. Oh, still swerving. It's brilliant play. It is a brilliant try, Stockdale.
Yeah, I know. Okay, so I'm being a bit of a buzzkill here because great to see. First of all, David Kilcoyne. Beautiful break, four prop forward. Keeps the ball, recycles it well. Ball comes out quickly. Jack Carty, the little dummy, gotta love that, goes in. Immediately he has somebody on his hips. That's Andrew Conway coming in off the right wing, now in support for his fly half. Great lesson for wings in terms of looking for work. When they say looking for work, that's what they're talking about. Conway goes on this weaving run, eluding players, making a couple of players look pretty foolish. And then we've got a moment here where Conway, in my opinion, really needed to pass this ball. Outside center, Chris Farrell coming in. What a great line he makes coming up through. And if he gets that short little pop pass right at this moment, he's free and clear to the line. He may have to angle a little bit outside, but you're number 13. You expect him to finish that. Instead, strangely, Conway keeps it and weaves behind Farrell. Now, here's the deal. Let's look at the finish, first of all. Beautiful. Fantastic pass from Conway. Out to Jacob Stockdale. Stockdale in at the corner. Everybody's happy. Pound the chest. Cheer. Fantastic try. Except that maybe it shouldn't have been allowed. You go back to that moment. Conway doesn't pass to Farrell. And what that does is it leaves Farrell just a little bit in front of Conway. Coming in to try and play a little defense. It's Owen Lane. He's the right wing for Wales. He's really the only one left. Now, I don't know if Lane could have put his hand up to block that pass out to Stockdale. I don't know. I mean, he's changing direction as that pass is being made. He's thinking about maybe going out and stopping Stockdale. I don't know if he could have done it. Probably not. But we'll never know because Farrell pushes him over. Now, going into the World Cup, I think we as fans and observers would really like to see some consistency in terms of officiating here. And my problem here is that if you had a defender go in and hit a ball carrier, not a non-ball carrier, an attacking player who didn't have the ball, he would be penalized, right? Tackling a player without the ball. But instead, here what we have is an attacking player pushing over a defender. That's blocking to me. That's shepherding. That's obstruction. It's a penalty. Now, again, we go back. We don't judge penalties really in terms of material nature for the most part. And certainly when it's a gray area, we're going to err on the side of, you know, what's fair play. Lane had a chance to stop this try. He wasn't given that chance, however, because Farrell pushed him over. In my opinion, you got to call that try back. In my rugby fan opinion, that would have been a shame.